Before watching the video, don't forget to subscribe the channel and enable bell notification to never miss an update from us.
Hello everyone and welcome to Entry Tunnel. This is Ashima and in this video, we will be talking about a new world record which has been created by K-Star, which is also sometimes called as a sun on Earth or Earth's sun. So this is an artificial sun which has been created by Korea, and this has created a world record recently of maintaining 100 million degrees for 20 seconds. Maintaining that 100 million degrees temperature at 20 seconds is the world record that K-Star has created. And this record is bringing in a lot of accolades, and it is paving way for further projects of nuclear fusion as we see. Now, why do we call it as artificial sun? Why is it that this thing has created world record and is receiving accolades from around the world? What is so special about it? What is this project all associated with? What is nuclear fusion? What is the difference between nuclear fusion and nuclear fission? All of that we'll be talking in this video. So stay tuned, and before we begin, do like the video, share the video and subscribe to the channel for more such videos. Now we'll be talking about K-Star. So first we'll be beginning with introduction of what K-Star is. K-Star is Korea's superconducting tokamak advanced research. Just a minute, let me change the color. Right. So Korea superconducting tokamak advanced research is the full form of K-Star. Right. Now, where is it located? It is in South Korea in National Fusion Research Institute. Now, where is this National Fusion Research Institute? That is in Daejeon in South Korea. Now, this was the first research center or research tokamak in the world to feature fully superconducting magnets. Right. It was supposed to be coming to force earlier, but due to the situation in the early years of its formation, that is economic cringe that happened in Asia, because of that was delayed, and finally it started its operation in 2008. 2008 was the year when it first created plasma. Its first plasma was created. It was completed in 2007, but when it comes to coming into force, that means it began its application or the purpose for which it was formed. That is creation of plasma, and plasma creation began in 2008. So we say that it was functional in 2008 in around June, right? Now, when we say that this project was basically something which was supposed to bring in nuclear fusion and bring the uses of nuclear fusion. So why do we say that nuclear fusion is a very difficult thing to attain and we are creating it such a huge arena? So first of all, let's see what nuclear fusion actually is. Nuclear fusion is a reaction which occurs on the surface of the sun, right? That is why it is sometimes, this K-Star is sometimes called, sometimes also referred to as artificial sun. Why is it called so? Because the process that happens over here, the nuclear reaction that happens over here is nuclear fusion reaction. And nuclear fusion reaction is the one which happens on the surface of Earth as well, on the core of Earth as, on the core of Sun, I'm sorry, on the core of Sun as well. So what is nuclear fusion? When deuterium and tritium nucleus, deuterium and tritium are both, these both are isotopes of hydrogen, right? First of all, these all are isotopes of hydrogen, heavy water, as we said, deuterium, D, and tritium, three, since three molecules and two molecules. So deuterium and tritium, which are isotopes of hydrogen, both of them fuse, and when they fuse, it becomes a five substance over here, you can see, like protons and neutrons, overall five masses there of five, and energetic neutron is released in this process. Helium nucleus is formed. Helium is what? It is a balanced situation. So a balanced situation or helium nucleus is obtained, and energy is released in this process. This energy which is released, it is a very huge amount of energy, and we have not yet began using this energy. Right? We do not do nuclear fusion. Now, even now, when we have so many nuclear reactors, do we have nuclear fusion? That answer you can get by the fact that when we study about nuclear reactors, we see that we need to, you know, bring in uranium. Right? Over here, we need isotopes of hydrogen, but we talk about bringing in uranium. Why do we talk about uranium? Because uranium is the product which is used in nuclear fission reaction and not nuclear fusion reaction. Right? So, if we talk about this whole reaction, energy which is generated, the energetic neutron and the energy which is generated is about 14.1 mega electronic volt in the neutron, and helium nucleus with alpha particle gives 3.5 mega volt of energy. This is the energy which is generated, and this is used in K-star. That is why it is called artificial sun as well. Right? Now, when we are talking about fusion and fission, what exactly is the difference between both of them? Let's have a look at that as well. In nuclear fission, a neutron hits uranium-235. And when it hits, it becomes uranium-236 because it has merged. After that, it will break open. Right? And after breaking open, there are going to be two elements which are going to be created along with a few free neutrons. Right? So 144 and 89 will be formed, and neutrons will be released, remaining neutrons, and this generates energy in fission reaction. Right? In nuclear fusion, deuterium and tritium, they both merge together, and after merging, they release a neutron and helium is formed. So this neutron which is generated, this gives out energy. Right now, we are using nuclear fission reaction for all energy production. But once we begin using nuclear fusion, once the mega project which we are working on for nuclear fusion, if that begins working, then we don't have to be dependent on any other source of energy for generating electricity, for generating power, because it will fulfill for like millions of years we can sustain via if nuclear fusion works. So right now, nuclear fission is working. Till we have uranium, we can depend on that. So now, once we are clear about what nuclear fusion is, what nuclear fission is, what kind of reaction happens in fission and fusion, let's have a look at what we are calling as tokamak, as we say. So what exactly is a tokamak? It is something as a coiled structure, as you can see over here, with magnetic field all around. So you can see toroidal magnetic field, twisted magnetic field, plasma current is there which is running between them. A vessel is there surrounding it, and outside it we have outer colloidal magnetic coil fields, and coil current is there, and colloidal magnetic field coils are present, toroidal magnetic field coils are there. So it is a huge structure which is created, and this structure is basically the one which you can say maintains that magnetic field that is required for creation, for you can say maintaining that temperature, for carrying out the reaction of nuclear fusion. Right. So if there is any nuclear fusion reactor, there is going to be a tokamak. Tokamak is going to be there if any nuclear fusion reactor place is there. So K-star, as we can see in the name of K-star, the T stood for tokamak because of the structure it represents. That is the magnetic field it is having. Right. So this is about what tokamak is, what is the use of tokamak as for that purpose. Right now, once we have a look at this, we'll be moving ahead with our world record. So when we talk about K-star, it attained 100 million, it was the first one to attain 100 million degrees centigrade for 20 seconds, maintaining that high degrees, that amount of temperature for 20 seconds is very like very big achievement, because as of now we haven't been able to do much of it. 50 million we have done for about, I guess, 101 seconds. China had done that. So China's East reactor had done 50 created a record of 50 million degrees centigrade for 101 point some seconds, right? But 100 million degrees centigrade is very, very large amount of temperature, and maintaining that for 20 seconds is in itself a huge record. So the first time this temperature was attained was in 2018, when 100 million degrees centigrade was attained at for 1.5 seconds. This was also done by K-Star. So K-Star had only done this reaction, or Korean's artificial sun had created this record. Now, what is the target? How we are increasing this? Why? What is the target we are trying to achieve via this? The target we are trying to achieve is that temperature should be greater than 100 million degrees centigrade, and it should be maintained for 300 seconds. Maintained means continuously there is a 100 million degrees centigrade, more than 100 million degrees centigrade by 2025. Right, and now this target is currently what K-Star is working for. But as of now, this discussion is going to happen about how this was maintained and how they attained this temperature. All of this is going to happen in the IAEA Fusion Energy Conference. Now, this conference is going to be held in May 2021, and it will be held in Vienna. And over here, the discussions are going to go on, and again, the further development of this whole project is going to go ahead. Right now, related to this, we have something called as ITER, which is also known as International Thermonuclear Experimental Reactor. Now, this reactor is being created in France. Currently, works are going on. They are creating it. It is in the process of being created. But what is important is that once it is complete, it will give us huge arenas and huge, you can say, heights of achieving nuclear fusion and putting that nuclear fusion energy into practical use, creating carbon-free source of energy. That is what this tokamak fusion device is going to do once it is completed and into work. Right, so what they are trying to do in ITER is attain 500 megawatt of energy they are trying to create or generate via a tokamak that they are generating. There are seven members, major members, being China, European Union, plus Switzerland. So we can say Euratom, and India, Japan, Korea, Russia, and United States. In Korea, we are talking about South Korea, right? So, the seven members are China, European Union, India, Japan, Korea, Russia, and United States. But there are other countries also which are participating in it in some form or the other. So, we can say that a total of 35 countries are there as of now who are working for ITER project. What is important is, first of all, where is this project of? This project is in France, right? And second of all, it is a fusion reactor, not a fission reactor, right? Third, once ITER is complete, it will be the largest of fusion reactors since 1950. Since 1950, whichever fusion reactor has been created, it will be the biggest of all of them, right? And after this is complete, like once we attain ITER, after that, there is going to be demo. Demo is going to be the first fusion reactor to produce electricity in experimental environment, obviously, once we learn to harness and maintain the temperature. So once ITER is successful, there is going to be demo, and this demo is going to bring electricity generated via fusion reactions to the table, right? So it is going to be a full-scale electricity producing fusion project. Now, when we are saying that the members are there, what exactly are these members going to do? There are certain contributions that are going to be done, right? So this is ITER, and what are they contributing? Each country is contributing something or other. Like cryostat is going to be contributed by India, right? This is the part which India is going to develop. Apart from that, what are the other parts? There's thermal shield, vacuum vessel, blanket, diverter, Central solenoid is going to be completely by United States of America. Correction coils completely by China. Feeders completely by China. And then toroidal field coils and poloidal field coils. We have already seen how tokamak, or you can say, works, or what tokamak is. This is a tokamak, right? So this hole is a tokamak, and how tokamak works and what are the parts of it, we have already seen in the previous slide. So the creation of those parts is going to be done by the member countries, and once all of them bring it together, they're going to bring fusion reaction to a point of discussion, right? So with this, we wind up the section, and I hope this has brought to you something new, or brought something new to the table. We'll see you in the next video, but before that, do hit the like button, share the video as much as you can, and subscribe to the channel for more such videos. Thank you so much, and have a wonderful day ahead.